This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Best practices. I actually don't like the phrase best practices. Too often in security, we want to abide by best practices, but who decides what's best? And if something is best for one firm, is it best for your firm? So too often we don't take the time to analyze what we're protecting to ensure that we're protecting it as well as we can. So I'm going to go over some things that I'm going to call minimum practices. Number one, two-factor multi-authentication. In my personal opinion, two-factor or multi-factor is now the must-have protection that every firm needs to have, and you need to determine how best to deploy it. Now, you'll hear from many that say for best practices, you shouldn't use text messages, other phone-based authentication techniques that could be potentially be cracked or hacked. But I'd argue the goal here, especially in the short term, is not perfection, but rather to be secure enough so that the attacker passes you by and goes on to the next victim. So you just want to be good enough with the goal to keep over time increasing. So again, have some sort of two-factor multi-factor authentication. Next, you want to prioritize patching. Too many times we patch workstations and we wait and patch servers. And especially these days, we've seen with the Exchange server attacks that wasn't the smartest thing to do. So you want to identify which one of those public-facing applications are you most at risk. When you get to the second Tuesday of the month, you want to look around at the patches that are being released from all of your vendors and say, okay, which one of these impact a public-facing thing? Whether it's a application, a server, even a device, a network hardware. Think in terms of VPN devices. Again, think in terms of how they can get inside your environment and prioritize the patches for those vulnerabilities that they're going to come after first. And sometimes you have to know your environment better than what we do now. Take the time to go through the ATT attack navigator view to see how they can possibly get inside your organization. And again, think in terms of how the attackers are targeting these days and how they're coming in and what you can do to change things and protect yourself better. You want to look at office macros and scripting controls. I've said this before, not everyone in your organization needs to have office macros enabled. So identify those people in your environment that need it and those people that don't, and disable macros where needed. Next, you want to review your options for controlling PowerShell and other scripting techniques. At least have PowerShell 5.1 deployed and consider upgrading to the recently released PowerShell 7 or 7.1. Passwords. And I'm not talking just about passwords that gain access to your environment. You need to think about where you're storing passwords for applications. Too often, we've seen passwords stored in GitHub repositories. So you want to make sure that when you have developers developing custom deployments for you, if they build in passwords into that deployment, make sure they're doing it in a proper way. Hashes, salted, not storing them. Make sure that they're trained to handle those passwords appropriately. They should not be stored in plain text, and they certainly shouldn't be put in a public repository. Microsoft has already put in something called secret scanning that scans through the public repositories for passwords to make sure that that's not put up there. Don't overlook the tried and true firewall. Many times we don't put in proper ingress and egress rules. Take the time to review, to understand what's coming in and out of your environment, and put in the appropriate rules. Next, you want to make sure you have logging, and if you have not deployed Sysmon in your environment, and you're not storing those logs either in Splunk or in Microsoft Sentinel, you want to make sure you take the time to pull those log files off and store them. You will need them someday. So make sure that you understand Sysmon and deploy it. So there you have it, my not best, but minimum practices. How many are you doing now? How can you strive to be better? We all need to do better as the attackers are getting much better than we are. As always, make sure you subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk YouTube channel. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.